The following few questions are about the water, salt, soda, and iodine combination claimed by Cayce to constitute the fundamental requirements of the body. Please gear your answers to the average body. Number one, what was meant that the body only requires these four elements? Can humans survive only on these?
The information should not be taken that it is these building blocks that the body itself can exist if these were only ingested or taken onto the body itself. Rather, these are the elements that would harness all aspects that would be given to the body to maintain the body. For instance, sunlight or light and sound are very necessary for the body as well. These would not be ingested, but the body would be exposed to them, especially the sunlight, of course, and the breath or the air that the body would take in would also be necessary to sustain the life. With this broader understanding, then, these elements that would be given should be considered necessary elements that if they were denied from the body, or if the body would be deplete of these elements, these substances, then the body would be in jeopardy and would be ill at ease, become sick, and even cease to exist as a living form. These are necessary elements, for they affect the atomic structure. These are the ingredients that keep the machinery working, so to speak, grist for the mill, you might say. But they are very important to keep a balance within the body, a harmony within the balance of the body. Understand the form is such that the body is exposed to all the elements, all the physical influences of the world, constantly. Throughout physical life, the body is accepting and rejecting things that are affecting it, placed on it, or placed in it. If you look upon a physical body and you think of it, there are things that come into the body, but there are at least four ways to reject or remove things from the body, including the pores and the exhalation, the body's filtering and rejecting or discarding mechanisms through the bowel and the kidney, etc., require a large amount of the body and require a large amount of activity or energy to be used in the body. Why? Because the body is exposed constantly to detrimental elements or influences that can cause it to be ill or to cease. And yet it continue to grow, become strong, procreate, and exist for many years. The planet is a hostile one. The influences are provided to balance the body between that that is derogatory and that that is complementary. These elements are the four, there is actually five, bases for existence and for life. Understand that if a body is in perfect harmony and works at longevity even from a young age, then the length of life would be more than what would be 10 times the age of puberty. When it is reached, you'll say. However, longevity is something that needs to be worked upon every day of the life. However, to the question, the body cannot exist only on these elements, but the body cannot exist without any of them. The denial of these, even in small amounts, causes imbalance in the life and physical health of a physical body, speaking at the general level as requested direction.
Could you describe the dosages and general routine of how to use the four elements?
Understand these are found in foods or minerals or items that the body would put into itself through the mouth or orally or topically upon the body, or even just laying against certain elements or touching them, handling them. It would be absorbed into the body. Gold itself would be good to handle or to ingest. However, to these amounts, trace amounts, a little each day, or taken in the food or put onto the food would be good. For instance, the sodium bicarbonate could be taken in a drink, or it could be found in water, placed in water, or found in water naturally. The sea salt would have the combination of iodine that would be easy to ingest, plus this type of salt would have the elements, including the sulfur, and the chloride, and nitrogen, that would be necessary to build the body at the cell level. Therefore, sprinkling this on food regularly, if the food is without salt, would be a good idea. But at least once a week, a pinch of salt would be good. Iodine may be taken by simply a few drops under the tongue, as to the atomic iodine or atomine itself. This should be done, rule of thumb, monthly, 3 to 4 drops. Where bodies are lax or have difficulty in thyroid function, then a few drops each week would be good till the body would lose the mass and, let us say, shrink the body to what would be more of a normal appearance. All elements should be taken in small amounts, and if found in water or with high degree of mineral content in the water, like zinc, or that it would be found in nuts, more like zinc, almonds especially, the body can reduce the amount given directly to itself. Otherwise, the amount should be at least weekly, a pinch of salt, a few drops of iodine, a sodium bicarbonate added to the water. See direction.
You've probably already answered this one, but what is the action of the four elements of the body? What benefits or changes will occur?
The body will be easier in its function. It will be, let us say, more youthful. The aging effects will be delayed or deterred. The body will be able to remain healthier and ward off any attack or invasion of disease, viral or bacterial, you'll say. The body's skin will heal faster, and the bone would heal faster if it was broken. But the bone itself would be stronger and would remain more elastic or flexible, as would be the arteries, you'll say. But more importantly, eliminations, where all disease begins in the body, in the elimination slowing down or the eliminations being impaired somehow. Here the eliminations would be improved, or the functions of the electrical and magnetical influences in the body would be kept at an optimum level. For each cell has a filament and vibrates at a certain frequency. Above and below the correct frequency, disease sets in. The body is either hyperactive or hypoactive, and as such, these imbalances breed diseasement physically in the form. However, the elements would allow the body to remain strong. Better teeth, better eyesight, better color of skin, less warts and blemishes appearing on the skin. Eliminations would be optimum, and the sexual influences would be normal or high. The appetites of the body in general would be good. The body would wish to be more active, more outgoing, and there would be a certain excitement for life. Depression or fatigue or even laziness would be minimized or non-existent direction.
Are there any risks with long-term consumption of sea salt, sodium bicarbonate, and atomidine?
None that we can see, unless, of course, they are taken in excess. For all things, taken in excess can be difficult to the body, but taken in moderation, as we have suggested, a rule of thumb, a pinch here, a few drops there, a mixture with water, balanced diet and movement or exercise of the body, and the functions would allow here the body to be improved or more accepted Well, you see, assimilation is more to what is accepted than what is given. For if a body has poor assimilation, even the best of the best that is given to the body will be useless, or practically useless, for it will not be properly assimilated. To have good assimilation, therefore, the body will continue to accept, and as it accepts, it grows stronger, remains more youthful, more alive. But if taken in excess, then the body would tend to be almost as if it would be poisoned, but it would not be by error at one particular point. It would take prolonged and willful exaggeration of these amounts taken into the body to cause any impairment, for there is a saturation point reached, and when that saturation point is reached, then the body will overreact or become unresponsive to what else would be given. It is better to be moderate than to have feast or famine with any element, but to these three, using common sense and a good rule of thumb, one can assess if the body needs or does not need any more, or may need a little more of one and a little less of the other. However, to the question, like sugar, a little is helpful, a lot is unpleasant. The elements can be taken in moderation, and on a long-term basis, we do not see any impairment or difficulty. Again, taken in moderation direction.
In a previous communication, you mentioned water, salt, soda, and iodine as four essential elements to the body, but that actually there are five. What is the fifth?
Iron.